Hey, it's Rondash Warrior. As you can tell, it is the last day of the month. Well, it's the last Sunday of the month, and that's usually when I record. I've actually finished like all of my classes or like courses for school. But the bad news is, since I went on a... What the fuck is up with my hair? No, yeah, but since I went on a semester abroad, here's a fucked up thing. I'm supposed to graduate. Yeah, I was supposed to finish all my classes by July, and I still had two more classes to do before July. Like, I, you know, the school stopped on, like, in August. Like, the semester ended in August, and I still had to do my summer semester, so that really sucks, because that means I have to graduate in 2015. Yay. But yeah, I've been thinking about what I want to do when I, like, now that it's pretty much over, like, you know, it's fucked up that I have to come back to Thailand to graduate in 2015, but, you know, but it's, like, better than not graduating, I guess, but, like, oh, it's stupid. Like, you know, there's another thing. I can go back to Boone and get a job for 4 to 6 months, but, I mean, like, I just came back, like, I just came out of Boone. Like, you know, it's just too sudden to just, like, just jump back in again. It's just really random, because, like, I'm not going to know anyone there, and the people I do know are seniors, and they're going to be too busy, like, trying to sort out their final exams, or, like, their final semester before they graduate. So that's, you know, that's kind of, like, why I don't want to go back. But there's a working holiday job in London, thinking of doing that. But what I really, really want to do is, I want to go back to, like, I want to go to Japan and see my friends, because I've been dying to go to Japan since I was, like, 15. So, yeah, my head's just, like, stuck in a rut at the moment, because, like, I still don't know what I'm going to do. Like, what was it? Next year, I want to go to University of Melbourne. But then I realised that I can't fucking stand my dad. Actually, I can't really stand fucking anyone in my family, to be honest. My ultimate goal, aside from wanting to be an animator, is to get away from my family as, like, just as far as possible. It's just so much, like, fucking shit I have to take from them. So, yeah, like, too much information, but not that much, I guess. I haven't really been doing anything this month. I've been watching a lot of movies and a lot of TV shows. Like, I'm watching Being Erica at the moment, and Being Erica is about a girl. She gets a therapist, or she meets a therapist that, like, can, like, have her go back in time and change things she regrets. The goal, like, I mean, it's, you know... it's a good TV show, but it's just, I think it's just pretty pointless, because even if she does change the situation or the whole scenario, she just goes back to square one. Like, I mean, she improves herself, and, like, she's more aware of why she didn't choose that particular road, but, like, she's just still not happy with it. But, like, since she, you know, has the power to, like, change the situation, she's more, I guess, she's more mature, she's, like, more self-aware of, I mean, she's more proud of, you know, why she chose that particular situation, like, even though she's not happy with it, she's content or sure of the situation, if that fucking makes sense at all. Jesus Christ, I sound like Kristen Stewart. But yeah, anyways, last night I watched The Conjuring. I was really skeptical of watching it because the director is known for making really shitty horror movies, Insidious. Insidious had a good story, it just wasn't scary. It was pretty shit. The story was good, but the movie, the special effects and stuff, it wasn't that scary. Another thing, what else have I watched? Yes, I watched Life of Pi. I thought that was gonna suck, because the director of that is the same director of Brokeback Mountain, and I don't know, I thought it was gonna be, like, cheap special effects, but it was actually a really good movie. I loved it. Like, it was really unrealistic, but, like, maybe, you know, like, the whole movie, like, the whole scenery of it, or, like, the art design, it looks fucking amazing. Like, you just, the whole time, you just feel like you're just tripping out on acid. Like, it's not a really good explanation, but, you know, things are, like, glow-in-the-dark, things are sparkly and colourful, and I don't know, I really love the movie. Recently I just finished reading, How to Tell If Your Cat Is Plotting to Kill You. That's a pretty funny comic strip. And I've had people, you know, when you're waiting for someone to talk to you again, but instead you get other people you haven't seen in, like, 2 or 3 years trying to talk to you, and you just really don't give a shit about them. Yeah, well, that's been happening with me. Like, I had a friend, she would only talk to me when she had a problem, and I'm just like, what the fuck are you doing here? Like, the last time we talked to each other, you gave me this really snarky comment, like, what are you doing here? It's like, you know, trying to I'm in this class because I'm trying to graduate like you are, but whatever. And you know, she was like, did you unfriend me on Facebook? I was like, yeah, well, I've kind of done that twice, but you kind of don't seem to get the message. And she was like, why? It's like, because you would only talk to me when you had a problem, and you would exclude me from, like, every time you wanted to hang out, you'd only exclude me. And she was like, oh, okay then. And she didn't have an explanation. She just unfriended me on Skype. It was so fucked up. Like, because, you know, we haven't really talked to each other in, like, 3 years, like, not properly. And then I had my ex talk to me last night while I was watching The Conjuring, and I haven't talked to him in 2 or 3 years. I think he unfriended me on Facebook when I started dating Gary, and it was just so fucked up because he was, like, saying stuff like, oh, you know, I went to Colorado or something for 2 weeks, and, like, I was getting laid every night. I was like, okay, that's good to know. And he was, like, saying, you know, I've got an amazing, oh no, I've got a girlfriend right now, and blah, blah, blah. It's like, it's good for you. You know, I'm obligated to be your friend because I just felt really bad for, like, I mean, when I first dated him, I did have feelings for him, but he just got really, really overbearing after 2 weeks, so I just feel obligated to be his friend. I just felt really bad, and I don't know, but I was just like, okay, that's nice, I'm happy. And then, you know, I was just like, you know, on spring break, I just hung out with my then boyfriend in LA, because he said he wanted to, like, yeah, well, my ex said he wanted to get LA. It's like, oh, your then boyfriend, like, did you mean blah blah, like, did you mean Gary? I'm like, yeah, you know, oh yeah, we broke up, but I kind of, like, I don't, you know, I wish him nothing but the best, you know, I don't, no hard feelings. Like, I mean, like, I felt really shit when we broke up, but, you know, just, it shit happens, you know. And god, what else has happened? Can't think of any. Oh, yes. After fucking seven, what the fuck is up with my hair? No. After 7 years, I finally defeated Resident Evil 4 on professional. Yeah, I keep forgetting the fucking tip of the Del Lago. What you do is you always swerve to the right to avoid hitting the logs. And that was definitely one of the biggest, like, definitely one of the hardest, like, games. Like, that was definitely one of the hardest stages to do. I was so pissed off because I was like, if I can't even get through the first fucking boss, what makes you think I can get through the entire game? Like, I was thinking that in my head. I didn't actually scream it out loud, but yeah. Eventually, I did manage to, like, beat the first boss. And, Al Gigante really wasn't that bad, okay? Like, he took maybe, I mean, he took a chunk of my health, but, like, he only took four rifle shots, and he took, I think, maybe two TMP rounds, I'm not sure, like, maybe two or three. Like, it really, Al Gigante really wasn't that bad. The wolves, I had a hard time with. The Garador wasn't that hard. The two Garadors were really hard to clock. I used the rocket launcher, like, on that stage, because when you get into the castle, or, like, the other part of the castle, there's two Algi, like, two Garadors, or the two guys with the Wolverine claws, and like a bunch of fucking Ganados. What was another hard level to do? Verdugo, I used the free rocket launcher on. What else? You know how the second time Ashley gets kidnapped, you have all these, like, fucking insects coming after you? I'm not saying this is, like, this makes things, like, you know, this makes things all, like, easy peasy, but what you can do is before Ashley gets kidnapped, you can walk into the door. Like, you can walk into the castle door, or you can walk around it, because, like, if you walk outside, there's a window, and you got the ladder, and then you can get, the broken, no, you can get, like, you can get a lamp, or, like, a butterfly lamp or something, I forgot its name. You can get a lamp, and, what was it, from the window to the little castle thing, like, before you go inside and Ashley gets kidnapped again, you can shoot it with a mine thrower, like, yeah, you can shoot it with a mine thrower three times, and, like, the whole hive just collapses. That makes, you know, it makes things, doesn't make things really easy, but it's more convenient than, like, having a shitload of insects, like, respawn from this hive while you're trying to, unlock the bridge. You know, yeah, unlock the fucking bridge, like, thing to get to the other side of the castle. The hardest part was, like, you know, after you finished the fight with Krauser, oh my god, that took a shitload of my health. Like, I had no health by the time I finished I finished the fight. Like, when you get into the first door with the turrets, after the Krauser fight, I couldn't do it. Like, I was so close to just quitting the whole game and restarting again just because I couldn't get past the three turrets. But what was it? I just learned you had to be really, really quick and really, really good or lucky with your aim. Like, what I did was I upgraded my mine thrower, thank God. Not fully, but, like, almost fully. And I shot the first turret with, like, two mine throwers. And then I ran as fast as I could to the other side, to the second turret, and I ran inside this, like, little building, like, this little hideout thing, and the second turret can't get you there, and you get your fucking jailbreaker and you shoot him. And then I got the rocket launcher. I brought a rocket launcher. Like, that was supposed to be for the Krauser fight, but luckily I didn't end up having to use it. But I got the rocket launcher and I shot the third turret. And at the end of it, I was so fucked because I only had four shotgun shells, and I only had 19, like, either 18 or 19 bullets on my TMP, so I couldn't reload. Otherwise, I'd be dead, and I'd have to restart the whole thing again with the three turrets. And I had no handgun. Like, I couldn't reload my handgun. Or, like, my Red 9, because, you know, if I reloaded, I'd die because I didn't. Like, I didn't reload, like, I didn't upgrade my reloading time or reloading speed at all. So I had to run as fast as I could. Like, I had to sprint as fast as I could down to the other door, before, you see Mike get killed. And I was just so fucking lucky that I got past the door, because I think there was a guy with a crossbow, and the guys with the crossbows always end up killing me. So I had to run as fast as I could before he shot me. Or like I must have like shot him like 2 times with a jailbreaker, but like luckily I managed to get through. And oh my god, like I just really fucking hated that level with 3 turrets. And god, what else? I could barely get past the last door before you before like you get the plagueis removed out of your body. Oh god, like, but I finally defeated Resident Evil 4 on Professional, and the only reason I wanted to defeat Resident Evil 4 on Professional was to unlock the fucking PRL laser cannon or laser remover. That was the only reason, and I mean, like, it was nice to get the infinite rocket launcher, like, even though you had to buy it for 1,000,000 pesetas, and you had to buy the Chicago typewriter for 1,000,000 pesetas. But that's all I wanted, the PRL laser, and it was for free after I completed the game. And holy shit, the Osman Sadler fight, like, I was just extremely. I fully upgraded my rifle. Like, I had to sell my jailbreaker and I had to sell my Red 9 to fully upgrade it. But fuck me, was I extremely lucky with like the accuracy or like the aiming of like trying to aim for his eyes on his knees. And by the end of the Sadler fight, I only had one red bar of health left. So it was just extremely hard to just like fucking. Because when you don't have a lot of health, you end up like running a lot slower than you usually do. So, I was pretty much like fucking limping to the boat. Oh, I gotta say, the rocket launcher doesn't do shit. Like, if you buy another rocket launcher to kill Sadler, it doesn't do shit. But yeah, when I ran out of all of my bullets, I didn't even need to use the rocket launcher. Ada, like, Ada throws you, obviously, Ada throws you a rocket launcher when she, what was it like, during the end of the boss fight, or like when it's almost done or something, or when he's like getting weak. And yeah, I didn't even need to use her rocket launcher. Like, I only used my Magnum, my mine thrower, and my jailbreaker, and then he just died. But fuck me, was that hard. I think I haven't. That was the second most infuriating game I've played on Professional. Oh my god, the most frustrating was fucking Fear 3. I just wouldn't play it for 2 days because I was so pissed because I couldn't get past the first boss. I'm not shitting you. But yeah, another thing that's happened. I'm actually getting really creeped out by one of my subscribers, 'cause like he would comment on every single video, and he would comment on like nearly all of my blog entries. And it's really fucked up, because like he didn't really give a shit about what I did. Like, we first met on DeviantArt, and then like, what was it? I don't know. Like, when I finally uploaded a picture of my face on it, or like when he finally found out what I look like, he just started like following me on Twitter, following me on like YouTube, and then following me on my blog. It was just really, yeah, he was just really freaking me out. Like, I don't know. And just like, I'd read some of his like replies on his Twitter, and like, I have no problem with like just someone that is only friends with the opposite sex, but he would just say things that you just wouldn't say in a normal conversation. So, that's another reason why I was like really freaked out. Sorry, my whole screen just went black. Probably because, I haven't touched the computer for like fucking 20 minutes now. Whoops. I really should get a job now that like I've graduated. I know I can't because, like, I can only speak English, and I live in Thailand, and I can't exactly just get up and go because I just have all the shit I've, brought over the years, living with my mum. So yeah, that's gonna be a bitch to move out. my cousins are coming over on New Year's. That's fucked up because I don't really get along with any of them, to be honest. And you know, one cousin always says that Thailand's corrupt, but she's coming here for New Year's. I don't know. And she hasn't seen my mum's side of the family, and I just think she's I honestly think she's just a bit too proud, or like too oblivious to realize that they're not going to be too happy seeing her. Because like my mum's side of the family is really snobby, and what was it? They're not really open either. She's like, oh, you know, it's gonna be great seeing your mum and like her family and stuff. And I'm like, yeah, I don't think they're gonna be too happy that you're the same age as me, you have two sons, and you're married. Yeah, that's gonna go down so well with my snobby family. But yeah, I think that's about it. I think on New Year's my two cousins are coming over. My best friend might, well, yeah, Katie, she might be coming on New Year's to Thailand, but I'm not sure. I'm thinking of doing a surprise visit for her when I get to Japan, but I've been looking at the ticket prices for that. Not very cheap. But yeah, think that's about it. See you later.
Doing it's my style. I'ma pick you up in a Cadillac like a gentleman. Bring it glamour back, keep it real to real.